please do not be frightened. I'm Sidney Brody. Please listen to me. When I learned that you were investigating the disappearance of the Millers, I had to find you. I worked in this hotel for many years, and I know my way around here very well. Yes, I do admit it, but I don't want to participate in the manager's plans anymore. Clarkson's been following you all the time, and he knows where you have hidden the Millers. They face great danger because Clarkson wants to sacrifice their souls to the demon. The demon is still only an intangible spirit, but after the ritual, he will obtain incredible, unimaginable power. I also know that there's an entrance from this place to Clarkson's secret room where we could find a way to prevent the fulfillment of his plans. Detective, remember those signs that you were finding when you started the investigation? First, it was a letter addressed to the manager. In it, I begged him to release the Millers, but he reworded the letter and tried to scare you with that "get out" on the reception desk. Remember the phone call where I prompted you to go to the gate in the attic? It was also me who wrote the inscription on the gallery in the lobby when I saw how Clarkson was trying to manipulate you. And how do you think William got that medallion hanging around his neck when you found him? I hung it around his neck so its magical power would protect him. I secretly took it from Clarkson, and I also learned from him that this medallion is a principal source of the magical power that could destroy the demon. Think about it. Why would I be telling you all this if I had been sent by Clarkson? Fear not. I will not let you down. But I'm very tired and hungry. You don't happen to have some food, do you? Thank you for the food. I got hurt on the way here, so I was looking in this room for some painkillers. I've been tossing everything in here, but I couldn't find anything to ease the pain. I did find, however, that there is some kind of cavity behind the wall of the fireplace. Maybe something is hidden there. If you happen to find any painkillers, Detective, I would be very grateful. Thanks, Detective. This has made me feel a little bit better. On the wall there is a puzzle, which after you solve it, opens the entrance to Clarkson's secret room. You will find the puzzle code by turning on the UV bulb in the old hotel swimming pool. There you will also find gas cylinders that are used to flame cut the metal. Try there to open the metal safe box that you found. Perhaps there will be a UV bulb there. Take this. I found it while I was browsing through the room. With these items, you will certainly manage to get to the other parts of the hotel. I'm not totally fit yet, but I'll wait here for you.
Thank you.
Good job, Detective. That's great. Now it's my turn. It is the manager's secret room, so I'll go in first to see if there's any danger lurking. I'm sure the safe containing the manager's documents is behind the door of this cabinet. I need to get to them, but not by using a shovel. Oh.
There's only the manager's diary. I wonder what I'll find in it. January 1786. During my business trip,
I got lost in the deep forest. Wolves frightened my horse and I fell down and got hurt. I would certainly have perished except for the cave in which I hid from the cold and from the wild wolves that had followed my trail of blood. The walls of the cave had strange paintings depicting an ancient ritual. Being exhausted and on the verge of death, I went to the darkest corner of the cave where I discovered a strange column from which a faint light was emanating. A few drops of my blood fell onto that column. What followed I could not have imagined even in my wildest dreams. The demon appeared, who, in the dark and distant past, had been worshipped by the ancient people, but whose name has long since fallen into oblivion. We have done business together. My life for other people's lives.
Let's see. The next record date will be April 1882.
From that moment on, I belonged to him, and I had to serve him. For many people, death means the end, but it does not concern me. The demon always requires new souls, and in exchange for them, he gives me energy and strength. My body does not age, and so I'm able to serve him further. Is this a blessing or a curse?
Year 1786. 1882. It cannot be. So the diary saying that Clarkson would live for centuries. Wait, what is in these old photographs? It's him, Clarkson. I'll look to see if there's some current record in the diary.
My master promises that this family will be the last victims. Then finally, he will emerge from the world of shadows, obtain a material body, and become immortal and invincible. That woman, however, is persistent. She managed to free the father and the son, and worst of all, she received the medallion of life and death and the four amulets of natural elements. If she finds the master's refuge and places them in his column, all will be lost.
The manager's certainly thinking about those amulets I have in my possession. I need to find the demon's column. His strength is hidden in it.